Okay, now we shall see few more points of distinction between economic growth and economic development. In the definition, I have already told you ki the basic difference, I am repeating it, ki production should increase. So that is economic growth. Okay, in the definition, I have dictated this, production increases. And here, production increases plus social welfare. And at this point, I have already dictated. So here, it is increase in production. And here, it is increase in production plus social welfare. So next thing is that can we measure economic growth means increase in production? Can we measure it? Yes, we can measure this with precision. So it is, can it be quantified? Yes, so it is quantitative concept. Quantitative concept. Can we exactly quantify economic social welfare also? Okay, well-being increased by 2% or 3% welfare. So it cannot be quantified. It is subjective actually. So it is actually a qualitative concept. Quality may improve, we can say, or deteriorate. So it's a qualitative concept. So this is quantitative and this is qualitative, because it cannot be quantified exactly. So it is, can be expressed in qualitative terms, improvement. Achha, apart from that, how many dimensions are there in economic growth? One, two, or many? How many dimensions? One only, one dimension or one aspect, that is production only, production of goods and services. So it is a unidimensional concept. Unidimensional concept. It has only one dimension, that is production. Achha, how many dimensions are there in this? One, two, or many? Many, because social welfare depends on a lot of factors like poverty, unemployment, average income of people, basic amenities, a lot of factors, even clean environment. So it is multidimensional. Multi-dimensional concept. Okay, so various dimensions are there. Achha, another is that economic growth, it can it be regarded as an ultimate objective of an economy? Can we produce goods for the sake of production? Yes or no? No. It is just a means. We don't want to produce more goods for the sake of production. Rather, because when people will use, their well-being will improve. So it is just a means, or it is an objective means. So it is just a means. It is just a means. So it means that it is not an objective. It is not the ultimate objective. And can we say it is an objective? Yes. So it is an end. End means objective in itself. It is an end in itself. Means end means objective. So it may be ultimate objective of an economy. Other point, is it, which one is easier to achieve? Growth or development?
Growth.
So mention this thing. It can be achieved. It can be achieved without economic development. It can be achieved without economic development. So we can achieve growth, increase in production without economic development. Okay, can we achieve this without economic growth? Yes, it's, we can't rule out, rather, because it's very rare. That, so we can say it can seldom be achieved, means very rare. So mention this, it can seldom be achieved. S-E-L-D-O-M, seldom is very rare. So it can seldom be achieved without economic growth. Economic development, it can seldom be achieved without economic development, without economic growth. So without growth, it is very rare that there may be economic development without growth. But we can't rule out. And there are two types of countries, you know, broadly. Developed countries and developing countries. In economics, developing countries may be called underdeveloped countries. So India is what, developed or developing? Developing. But in economic literature, developing word is also used for underdeveloped country. So we will discuss in next chapter exactly. So developing country and underdeveloped may be used interchangeably. So now there are two types of countries, like developed and developing. So which country will focus more on economic growth? Developing will focus more on growth or development? Like India should be focusing more on growth or this? Or alternatively, America is a developed country. So America should be focusing more on growth or development? Normally, developed countries focus more on growth. Yes. So, and developing usually on this. So relate, it's a matter of degree only. So every country want both the things. They are both interrelated also. So, but relatively, developed countries focus more on that. To mention that in this, it is a major concern of economic growth. It is a major concern of developed countries. Major concern of developed countries. So major concern of developed country. And it is a major concern of developing countries. But it should be clear that we are talking about major concern. It's a matter of degree. Every country wants both the things. Is it true or is it reverse? Does it hold? Now, you know ke, what kind of economic system is there in developed countries? America or mainly other developed countries? Mein? Capitalist system is there. So capitalist system can ensure which thing? Growth or development? Growth. So, from this actually, it reflects that they are focusing more on growth. And in India, we have normally developing country mixed. It means that actually government intervene too for achieving social objectives, etc. So it's a matter of degree only. I think what the point? Okay, now the last point is that indicators. How we measure economic growth? Indicators. So what are indicators? How we measure economic growth? Any idea? Investment. Infrastructure. Capital. Economic growth. I told you. GDP. And GDP means we call it always real GDP because it should be actual increase in production. So real GDP. Real GDP. So economic growth is measured by real GDP. As I told you, our economy grew by 7.1% last year. So it means that our real GDP increased at 7.1%. So actual production increased by this. Okay. Or even real per capita income could be used. Real per capita income. Means average income. If average income is increasing, we can say the economy is growing. So real GDP or real per capita income. Okay, I think it is clear. So real GDP and real per capita. But normally, which is commonly used? GDP is more commonly used. Like when, as I told you, in India or in world as well. Achha, what are indicators of this? The most famous indicator is Human Development Index, HDI. Achha, but before HDI, you know, earlier some other indicators were also used. Like before that, PQLI was very famous indicator earlier. So briefly, we'll discuss these. Just write down short form only. So we'll discuss each one by one. Physical quality of life index, PQLI. Achha, even real per capita income was used earlier. Real per capita income was also used. One indicator is new, etc. So there are various indicators of economic development. This we will discuss just after this in our next section. So I think basic difference between economic growth and economic development should be clear.